Yes, sir! What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BKA the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video, man. Check it out. First thing, check the link in the description, cop some merch. We vegan strong around here, man. Y'all already know what it is. But this is my NBA 2K19 early review, man. This is one of those things where you just talk, well, I'm just going to talk about the game, give you guys my opinions on the game so far. And we're just going to go from there. First off, I am loving the game when I can find people to play with. I can hardly ever find people to play with. So if you want to play, I'm on Twitch. I'm on YouTube. I always stream. Please come through and carry your boy, because I play center and I play small forward. I cannot play this game by myself. It's extremely difficult, especially if I expect to win. And y'all know I'm not ready to do raising with randoms just yet. So y'all already know the first thing, but like on to the review. The first thing that you're going to notice is in the game, you get a lot more VC. Look at this. You get normally when you got a win last year, it was like 200 VC, if that, 100 and some odd VC. Sometimes we go on 30 game win streaks and I barely get 1,000 VC. It will feel like you barely make the money back that you made from Gatorade. So now you're seeing that you're going to get a lot more VC. You can go spin the wheel. You can go do a whole lot of things. The one thing that I do like about this game is there's a lot of ways to make VC. There's a lot of ways to just have fun and go play by yourself. If you want to play this game by yourself, you can go to the Under Armour cages and play there. And it doesn't count against your record, and it's a boatload of fun. If you want to play the game with your team, you can go to the Jordan Rec Center. You can go to regular team program, or you can even go to, where else can you go? You can even come out here to the park and play. If you're really worried about your record though, I just go to the Under Armour cages. You can work on badges there, and you can just have some fun. So that's that type of gameplay. That's the middle ground. It's a silly way to just have fun, but it's not a complete waste of time because you can work on your badges there. Now, out here at the park, it's going to be a little bit different. One thing that you're going to notice right off the bat about the game is all the ratings and all the little stuff that they told you, it's really not true. You can play this game, you can momentum. Let's say with guards, you can play the game, you can momentum, you can get dribble moves and all that good stuff, and you don't have to have the same ratings that they're talking about. I want to say Brutus Sim put that video out and said like an 89 or 79 or 82, you can momentum dribble, and that's absolutely correct, because Man Grindhard has a slashing shot creator with shot creating first, slashing second. He's momentum and nobody can stay in front of him. You check out his video, you know that. You see players in the low 70s and the high 70s with three-point ratings and mid-range ratings. They can hit shots consistently. If you can shoot on this game, you can shoot. There is a open shot boost, and if you're shooting, you're shooting. That's the biggest thing that I like about this game is there's variety. There's room for everything. You got room for the pure lockdowns, which we're going to talk about that in a second. I don't even know if I make a pure lockdown right now because everybody's prime time. I'm making a video on that soon. But you got pure lockdowns. I got a two-way stretch five. Anonymous has a pure point forward. These guys that we're about to play, they have a slashing defender and a pure point forward. The way that we play the game, and I just made this guy, so I just got on the game and said, yo, who do you want me to bring? Said bring a shooting center, because the way that we play is not unlike, he just isos. It's kind of like Steezo, where Steezo isos and gets buckets. Assist game, he isos to get three. So he isos to get me open and get a shot, but he also goes to the rim and gets a lot of buckets himself. So he'll kill his man, but he's killing his man to force a double team and then, you know, force a three. Now, the one thing that I was saying is he's got a pure point forward and I got a two-way. We both have low 70 jump shots. And to be honest, you don't even really notice it. We can shoot the ball just like anybody else, just like any sharpshooter. Now, if you feel like you need an extra boost, by all means, make a pure sharpshooter, make a shot-creating sharpshooter. I would probably make a shot-creating sharpshooter, shot-creating first, sharpshooting second. But if you need the extra boost, put the sharpshooter first and the shot-creating second. I would probably make one of those because you're going to be a lot more versatile. The reason I put shot-creating first is because you get better badges and, you're just going to be more potent. Now, that brings us to the defense. Defense on this game is a whole lot better. You don't want to be just completely one-dimensional. You want to be able to do something on defense. Look at that right there. If you dribble into people, you're going to give the ball up. If you make bad passes, you're going to give the ball up. People are going to steal the ball on the perimeter. And it is sometimes excessive, and sometimes it does feel trades up, green bean, money teams, splash down. Look at that. I got like a 73-3 and I can green it. It does feel excessive sometimes, and it does feel like it's OD. It doesn't feel excessive when a good player does it, but when you get bad players that really don't know anything about the game other than just spamming square, like, you know, the square spamming fest that we had last year, that's when it starts to get annoying, and anybody can beat you if they do that. And what I mean is, you just see people come out and just square, square, square. Anytime your player pauses, they hit square because they feel like they can intercept the pass. Anytime you're dribbling, they just hit square the entire time they're on defense. So they're just pushing square to play defense, and it doesn't make sense because it just gets irritating. Now, I don't think they should tone down the interception some, only for that reason. If they did, it will only be for that reason. Like right there, that's a good pass. He reached for the ball. He couldn't get it. But sometimes you get an animation where you just turn and just pick it off. So if he was on the right plane, and that's another thing. Sometimes people are on the wrong plane, and they still get the animation, and they still get the steal. So that part I'm not really worried about because I know there's something they'll fix, but it really does beg the question, why even make a lockdown defender or anything like that if everybody can press square and take it and just rip somebody as well as get interceptions? It's a little bit iffy to me. I don't know how I feel about it. Trey, you see, he's able to hit that shot. I don't know how I really feel about it because we haven't had the game long enough. I think everybody just needs to adjust. I'm always of the opinion that everybody just needs to adjust and figure out how to play the game. If you're getting ripped, you're probably dribbling too long in somebody's face. If you're constantly losing the ball, you're probably just running into somebody with the ball. And if you're constantly getting the ball stolen and all that, then you're probably just making bad passes. That's why I'm trying to be of the opinion. But at the same time, sometimes it just does get excessive with players just spamming square. And that's been in every 2K that's ever been, so it is what it is. Like I said, you get a lot more VC. There's a lot more ways to have fun. You got Under Armour cages. You can work on badges. Look at that. Game time! You know, we got the takeover badge, and it was all good. You got a lot more ways to have fun that don't count towards your records. You can work on your badges. You can do all of that good stuff. 2K really looks like they tried this year to up the gameplay, number one. Create a skill gap, number two. And like I said, that's a little hazy because anybody can do it. That's where things get obsessive. When anybody can do it, that's when it gets a little bit, you know, I don't know really what's going on with this or how we're gonna reconcile this, because anybody can just press square and get steals, whether they're just ripping you or they're doing anything else. And, you know, but like I said, the game is a lot of fun. Defense is a lot better. You're not just gonna come out here and just shooting people's faces like you did last year, but at the same time, you can, because if they don't contest the shot, it doesn't do anything. Another thing is, and I didn't get a chance to show you here, if you take a contested shot, your shot meter will turn red. You immediately know the shot is contested, so you probably know that you probably need to go play defense, or you need to get down there and try to get the rebound. That's something that a lot of people probably haven't noticed, but it definitely does turn red if you take a contested shot, and your chances of hitting that shot are very minimal. Wide open shots seem to go in a lot more, and if you take wide open shots, you get a little boost to your shot and all that good stuff, so you're going to be good. All in all, create what you want. Play the way that you want to play. Don't worry about the ratings so much unless you're trying a momentum and speed boost and all that good stuff, because there's a lot of people that are going to be able to do it. And then when you get hot, when you get in the takeover, you're going to be able to do it anyway because it's going to add plus 10. So if you had high 70s, let's say if you had 76, when you get the takeover, you're going to have 86 ball control. So you're going to be able to just bop, 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 you know, kill people anyway. So all in all, I give this game probably an 8.5. It's a really good game. It's really fun. The only thing is that right at the, you know, the stealing is a little bit excessive, but I don't want them to change anything. We got Man Grindhard calling me right quick. Yo, what up, bye? Yo. Hello. Yo. Bigger. Hey. Hold on 1 second. But anyway, hopefully they don't change the thing and we just get it. I tried to get Man in on the video real quick, but it looked like it ain't working. It ain't letting me put him on speakerphone. There you go. Yo. Yeah. Are we missing double rep?
Yeah.
Hey, look, real quick, get your quick thoughts on the game of 10 seconds of what you think about the game. I know what you think. They don't need to change a damn thing.
Ain't got nothing bad to say about the game, bro.
Exactly.
I really don't, my nigga.
Hey, exactly.
I ain't got type out of it, bro. I fuck with it.
Exactly. Hey, look, about the stealing and all that, what did we say yesterday? You turned the ball over 10 times in pro-am, what you said. I just need to adjust. That's just it.
That shit on me.
Yeah, so... Like I said, like I'm trying to tell them, the stealing does get to seem obsessive. And if you just want to play the game the way that we used to play in 2K18, then, yeah, you're going to get mad at the game and be like, yo, they need to change this stealing. But if you realize that you can't dribble in people's faces and you can't dribble forever and you actually dribbling with a purpose, you don't have no problem. And if you make good passes, you'll be straight. So you don't got nothing bad to say about it? Bet. Well, I'm about to get on and we about to play. Ladies and gentlemen, that's our review. Just don't change the thing. Just leave the game like it is. Let us figure it out, 2K. And everybody can shoot. So like I told them, don't pay attention to those shooting ratings. Everybody can shoot. As long as you in the 70s, you good. And you shooting wide open shots. You straight. But anyway, we about to get on. Y'all make sure y'all watch the stream. And we're going to holler at y'all. Till next time. It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop. BK the People's Champ. Holla. And I'm out.
Paul on too.
Bitch. All right, I'm on now then. Oh, also, the VC prices are about the same. If you wanted to know, VC prices are about the same, man. It's like 200,000 VC is like $50. And that will get your player maxed out too, so just know that. And I'm gone. Y'all take it easy. Peace. We about to play right now, so I'm probably playing right now on YouTube or Twitch. And y'all check me out. Link in the description. Gone.